Good evening, dearest friends, and welcome into our sacred pentagram full moon approach. It's second day and in Sagittarius. And we are going to have, I think it is already in 1 hour. If Michael, you can put the pre-full moon meditation, I think it is 8:30. I'm sorry, 7:30 p.m. GMT. That is my memory of it. So that's why we just go ahead into our meditation and try to find our attitude towards these pouring energies. And then we have also the full moon already in what it is about 7 hours. Is it so that we are starting? We start 2:30 a.m. GMT. So, or is it two? Yeah, around that 7 hours. So the full moon is also coming very soon, and the pouring energies are very tangible. So let us go within and again align ourselves into that period of the sacred time of the full moon. And we align with the idea of the first disciple. Thus it is said that in one sense, Sagittarius is representing now the true disciple. We have the idea in Scorpio, the earlier sign in Scorpio is the victorious disciple. But now Sagittarius is the one which is guarding the gate. And when we can respond to higher energies of Sagittarius, that energy truly takes us into the narrow path of discipleship, one-pointed disciple who is not anymore waving back and forth, but is able to keep one's directives and direction in the goal and fulfill the Dharma. That's why when the time of Sagittarius comes, it brings also a kind of upliftment. Sagittarius is truly wonderful in its energy. When we have been going through the tests in Scorpio and we are responding like Saturn in Sagittarius, then we have a trustworthy disciple who is just keep on going, as if you remember Churchill, who said, if you are walking through hell, keep on going. I am becoming like Michael. Michael was repeating certain things. At least how long did I know him? It was like 25 years. There were certain things what he was repeating, and maybe I am coming a little bit like that. But anyway, we remember now about the Sagittarius. It's wonderful energy to be aligned with and to invoke, and also align with that great strength in joy. So let us align with Sagittarius, and we try to reach this higher part of Sagittarius. Now also, let us remember the words of Master DK. He says, the hierarchy waits with patience the fruition of its efforts after doing all that can be done on all planes. Full moon time is the one of hierarchy's moment of cooperation with humanity via disciples. And again, let us take that really as he says, and know that we are needed for their work. During these, it is advised that the whole 24 hours we should be very ready in these sacred times, the 5 days, 2 days after, 2 days before the full moon are those which we should be extremely aware and constantly vigilant what we are needing to be doing and how we are needed. Going into silence and reflect as much it is possible with our mundane world to be in meditation and in silence. So he continues, I would ask you to make a careful record every full moon from 2 days before until 2 days after the full moon of all experiences and visions. So just reflect the past month from the full moon of Scorpio and this full moon. And remind yourself about the goals that you were setting forth during the earlier full moon. What did you learn? Try to be really like a guru to yourself. Sagittarius is one of the guru signs. So be the guru to yourself. And see what were those spiritual pearls that you can in your psyche find and what you can use again forward in your life, in your fulfilling your dharma. Reflect those things. We continue during these days doing that. Also, take into your consideration the light which is related to Sagittarius. It is such an amazing explanation that DK is giving. It's so revealing. The light which is related to Sagittarius is a beam of directed, focused light. In this, the point of light becomes the beam, revealing a greater light ahead. And illuminating the way to the center of the light. I still read again. In this, the point of light becomes the beam, revealing a greater light ahead and illumining the way to the center of the light. And if you think about the fire triangle, we have Leo, which is that point of light. We need to find that point. It is so important to realize the point of light and how we are holding it. We cannot do anything in spiritual sense if we don't find that point of light. But now it becomes the beam. And there we can understand why Sagittarius is said to be the first disciple, the first real disciple. We need that beam of light, which is revealing still a greater light ahead and will illumine then the way to the center of the light. Also, you can now define to yourself short-term goal during this full moon. Send forth the beam of light and find the light of the hierarchy. Alignment. Now align with your brothers and sisters around the planet. Recognize your group by its quality. Send love and goodwill and align with the work that we are working together, and as the sign of the sacred work of building the chalice of Christ consciousness upon the mental plane, place upon the altar blue rose . Realize that behind the second decanate of Sagittarius there is the constellation which is called Ara, the altar. We can align with that constellation which is about dedication and which is about the sacred inner work of the disciple, the communion with the higher, with the master, and what includes the oaths. So we are aware of this. And we also align with our triangle work. Plural sisters can align with the plural triangle and visualize the Christ in the center of the triangle. And we can visualize the strong network of golden triangles around the planet. Now align with the planet Venus. The planet through which the soul qualities are entering into our system. And again, those who know their horoscope and chart reflect where Venus is found in your natal chart. And with that secret Dharma, what is planned by the soul for this life, where you really work deeper ways the soul qualities into your life. Sacred pattern and divine symbol which is formed in the skies by Venus, Earth and the Sun, creating the five-pointed star or five-petaled rose, which is a very old and ancient symbol found around the world. Giving us understanding of the teaching which has been given to humanity ages and ages ago. Sacred symbol of the soul, the mother. And of initiation. Visualize the sacred pentagram, five-pointed star above the group, pouring out the indigo blue light. Know that what is said for this time of the forerunner, that that time the initiation is truly possible.
Namastasye.
And we hold also helping the humanity. We hold that symbol above humanity. Visualize that in the center appears the blue rose, indigo blue rose. It starts to rotate and circle faster and faster so that it forms indigo blue disc. It is the sacred door within. Stand behind that door and align with that what is behind the door. Walk through that door. You find yourself standing in silence. Start to see before your eyes a living indigo blue lotus flower with 108 petals. Every single one of those petals are sacred powers of deity. All of those powers have a certain name. The name of that particular divine tool, energy, quality, antidote against one of the 108 sins. All those hindrances which are stopping the ways of the soul, but which has to be conquered. And that is the dilemma and the mystery, that by conquering one of the qualities of Hydra, we gain at the same time the divine psychic power. This is the old, ancient ways of contemplating and directing oneself towards these sacred divine powers, which can be invoked, which can be taken as one's own by going through what is needed. And for that, one is sounding in different numbers, different measures. It's the old Hindu techniques or Vedic techniques, and also Buddhist techniques, to repeat those divine names. You are standing upon one of those petals and sound your own sacred name. And via that we can align with the work that we are building virtues into the chalice upon the mental plane. That chalice that we are all building together. And also the chalice that we are going to give to Christ on 25. We are going to use the power which is Vasu Prada, bestower of wealth. It's one of the Lakshmi names. And that means it's not meaning only something physical. It is all kinds of riches, inner riches, the soul riches that we can have and which are pouring out, which are given freely to others. So let us now sound 108 times your sacred name and then Vasu Prada. And let us prepare ourselves for the full moon in silence, a few moments. And let the energy of Vasuprana be distributed via the group into the empty world, which is empty from spiritual richness. Let us again strengthen our alignment with the hierarchy and with the great Lord, the Christ. Feel divine love sweeping through you and through the group. Radiate the divine love through your heart, through your mind, through your hands and feet. And be ready to be available.
Thank you.
Great invocation. From the point of light within the mind of God, let light stream forth into the minds of men. Let light descend on earth. From the point of love within the heart of God, let love stream forth into the hearts of men. May Christ return to earth. From the center, where the will of God is known, let purpose guide the little wills of men, the purpose which the masters know and serve. From the center, which we call the race of men, let the plan of love and light work out, and may it seal the door where evil dwells. Let light and love and power restore the plan on earth. Oh. Let us now bless the group, and let us bless our sisters. Let us say together, I bless you, my beloved sisters, the mothers of the Christ. Let us bless our brothers and say, I bless you, my beloved brothers, the protectors of the Christ. May the blessings of the Holy Ones pour through the group into the worlds. May all sentient beings be blessed and directed towards the light. Thank you, dearest friends. We stop now here, and in 15 minutes there's going to be the pre-full moon meditation. And also 2:30 a.m. GMT is going to be the Sagittarius full moon meditation. We welcome all of you there. Have a beautiful full moon time, and let us be for the work and for the hierarchy. Lots of love to everybody, and thank you.